So in the last lecture, we were looking at the linearized Burgers equation, and we discretized this equation using forward time and central space differencing. So this equation could be written in the following manner. So we had ui n plus 1 minus ui n by delta t plus c ui plus 1 n minus ui minus 1 n by 2 delta x is nu ui plus 1 n minus 2 ui n plus ui minus 1 n by delta x square. And then I had mentioned that the modified equation corresponding to this discretization equation is the following. So it has the same time derivative and space derivative terms, except the right hand side has this modified dissipation term, where the variables r and lambda are the following. So we also looked at the graphical representation of stability curves. Now let me start with a very heuristic stability analysis, and that would be based on very simple arguments. Now note that since we're modeling a dissipation equation, or we're modeling a diffusion based equation which has a convective part, clearly this is actually the modified viscosity in our problem, which would be definitely closer to nu if delta t is a small number. But nevertheless, we would want that this number physically should always be greater than zero, which means nu minus c square delta t by 2 should be greater than or equal to zero, just based on physical arguments. This gives us some understanding or some limit on what should be an acceptable value of lambda in terms of r. So how do we get that? Let's go on. This equation basically will now give us c square delta t by nu is less than or equal to 2, and I can now write this as, or if I multiply the denominator and numerator by delta t, and also multiply and divide the denominator or the numerator and the denominator by delta x square, I can now write this as c square delta t square by delta x square would be less than equal to 2 times, now you notice here it would be 2 times nu delta t by delta x square. And so the left hand side is lambda square and the right hand side is 2r. So a heuristic analysis tells us that lambda square should be less than or equal to 2r for the equation to be physically resembling the equation that we are intending to solve. But following the rigorous von Neumann stability analysis that we did in the last lecture, one also obtains that r is less than or equal to 1 by 2. So this is using the von Neumann stability analysis. And this means if I plug this in, this value of r less than 1 by 2 here, clearly we get lambda square would be less than or equal to 2r, which is less than or equal to 2 times 1 by 2, less than or equal to 1. So lambda should be less than or equal to 1. Now this lambda square less than or equal to 2r is a necessary condition for stability. Further, this condition can be interpreted in the following manner, or in many books actually you will see this condition sort of written in this way. Some books would write c square delta t by delta x square, which we wrote as less than 2 times nu delta t by delta x square. So delta x square can actually be cancels on both sides. 1 delta t goes from here, this cancels with, and this remains as 1. And then what we can do is we can write this as c delta x by nu times c delta t by delta x, which would be less than or equal to 2. And c delta x by nu is essentially what we call as a cell Reynolds number, REC. So REC times lambda is less than or equal to 2, or we get the cell Reynolds number is less than or equal to 2 by lambda. So as I said, REC is the cell Reynolds number. The cell Reynolds number happens to be an important parameter in the analysis of the Burgers equation. And so what I wrote was, this is C delta x by nu. Now you can notice why it is called as a cell Reynolds number, because it's defined on a length scale. So the length scale is based on the size of the cell or size of the grid. And that is the reason we call it as a cell Reynolds number. Now the next issue that I want to talk to you about in this lecture is the nature of the solution when we use the forward time and central space differencing scheme, and the appearance of wiggles in the solution, which typically happens when REC is less than or equal to 2 by lambda, but it's more than 2. And I will illustrate these wiggles by an example, but let me first talk to you about what these wiggles or oscillations are. So if you look at, let's say, solution U versus the location, what we would see in a solution is that we will have a sudden change that I've shown here, a sudden change that would appear, which would be non-physical. So these kinds of wiggles in the solution, they would remain bounded throughout because REC would be less than 2 by lambda, and which is actually under the regime of stability. And secondly, this is a non-physical behavior, and I will try and address why this non-physical behavior even comes out in the solution. So to address this, let's look at the discretized equation. We had ui n plus 1 minus ui n by delta t is minus c ui plus 1 n minus ui minus 1 n by 2 delta x plus nu ui plus 1 n plus ui n minus plus ui minus 1 n by delta x square. And I could write this as ui plus 1, I could write this as ui n plus 1 to be ui n minus c delta t by 2 delta x ui plus 1 n minus ui minus 1 n plus nu delta t by delta x square into ui plus 1 n minus 2 ui n plus ui minus 1 n. So if we rearrange terms, and I would now combine like terms, what we'll get would be ui n minus 2r ui n plus r ui plus 1 n minus lambda by 2 ui plus 1 n plus r ui minus 1 n plus lambda by 2 ui minus 1 n, which would be in the next step ui n multiplied by 1 minus 2 r plus r minus lambda by 2 ui plus 1 n plus r plus lambda by 2 ui minus 1 n. Now let's look at this equation very carefully. So this equation is saying that the value of the variable at location I at time n plus 1 is in terms of values at time n, except now let's look at the coefficients, which are even hold a lot of importance here. This coefficient 1 minus 2 r by stability requirements, when we said the solution has to be stable, and that is also one of the reasons why r comes out to be less than or equal to 1 by 2. So this requires, or this would always be greater than or equal to 0, because r is less than or equal to 1 by 2. As I said, r less than or equal to 1 by 2 can also be explained from this equation, because when you look at this equation, what it's saying is that if there is no heat generation, or there is no generation term in the problem, clearly the value at time n, right, if the value is increasing, this coefficient has to be positive, because this coefficient is positive here. So these two have to be of the same type. So this number has to be greater than or equal to 0. Now if you look at the other coefficient, if r minus lambda by 2 is less than or equal to 0, which basically means that lambda is greater than or equal to 2r, this would mean, in other words, this would mean c delta t by delta x is greater than equal to 2 nu delta t by delta x square, which implies c delta x by nu would be, which is what is the cell Reynolds number, would be greater than equal to 2. So this will be less than equal to 0 when the Reynolds number REC is greater than equal to 2. Now this is what creates a problem in our solution, because the third coefficient here is always greater than 0. So why does this create a problem? To address this, let me take a sample problem. Say we are solving a problem in which the variable x at time t 0 is 0. Let's say it's on the 1D domain, the boundary conditions are imposed at x equal to 0 and x equal to L or x equal to 1. So x is 0 here, x is 1 here. X u at 0 comma t is, let's say, 0, and u at 1 comma t is, let's say, 1. And let's take 11 grid points. So you have certain number of grid points along this axis. So we have 11 grid points, including the boundaries. So if I number them, point number 1 would actually correspond to, or node 1 would correspond to x equal to 0, node 11 would correspond to node, the last node on the domain. And so that data is already given as boundary conditions. We need to calculate for this 11 point grid what would be the solution on the internal points, where I will go from 2 to 10. Now when we're starting the solution, which means that n would be 0 because the initial condition is given. So let me show you what would happen to the solution right at the first time step. So we will calculate ui at 1, where I goes from 2 to 10. Now it's easy to see that if I put I from 2 to 9 in this equation, if I, let's say, is 2, u2 at 1 would be u2 at 0, which is 0, this goes to 0, u at 3 at 0, which is also 0 initially, because all the variables all values will be 0 initially, and this will also be 0 because the boundary condition at x equal to 0 is 0. And the same thing will happen for all grid points till I is less than equal to 9. So for I less than equal to 9, ui 1 will actually be 0. What it means is that we are sort of here in this section, if I can say that we are going all the way till up to 0.9, it's still the initial condition, it's still 0. Okay. Now let's look at what happens at I equal to 10. For I equal to 10, we will have u10 for the first time step to be 0 plus r minus lambda by 2 times u. This would be 11, which is the same at all time steps, plus again 0. If you look at this equation, ui minus 1 at the last time step is still 0. So we only get this additional term. Now this is equal to ui 11 being the boundary condition, being equal to 1, as I mentioned here. So this will be equal to r minus lambda by 2, and which I have shown now is less than equal to 0 for REC to be greater than equal to 2, which is also corresponds to lambda greater than equal to 2R, which is the same condition. So now what this does is, at the 10th point, we will actually have a negative solution. So the solution that you will see would be straight till here, and then a non-physical solution, and then again it will go to the boundary condition. Right? So if I plot it here, just for representation, what you would see is that the solution will be all the way 0, and then it would exhibit at the next grid point, it would exhibit a negative value, and then it will go to 1 at the, so this is what you will see, that it will be 0 all the way. The 9th grid point will show you some still 0 value, 10th grid point is here, and this is the 11th grid point. So we have a non-physical oscillation. Now these non-physical oscillations can be eliminated if you use a first order differencing, if we use a first order differencing for the convection term or the convective term, and this is what is called as upwind differencing. So say C is greater than 0, that the flow is from left to right, then this interpretation would mean that I could write the discretization equation as ui n plus 1 minus ui n by delta t plus c times ui n minus ui minus 1 n by delta x. So this is the first order differencing is nu times ui plus 1 n minus 2 ui n plus ui minus 1 n by delta x square. Now I leave this to you to prove that the modified equation for this discretization equation is the following: ut plus cux is nu times 1 plus rec by 2 minus c square delta t by 2 uxx plus higher order terms. Now clearly, as we see here, viscosity is augmented because of this additional REC term that we see in this problem. And if REC is more than 2, this actually is sort of even doubling the viscosity in a way, numerical viscosity. And so this kind of solution will exhibit higher dissipation. So we will notice higher dissipation in this solution when REC is greater than or equal to 2.